Welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition as we continue our trek through this lovely bog known as the Fallow Mire. Saturate the area with bees. Ready to enter the match.
Thank you.
see why it's advantageous to come in here with range now, huh?
Away with you!
We will want to launder our clothes later, or burn them.
I think burning is the preferred for a place like this. I gotta fast travel back to reload.
Yeah. work. We have a path free of corpses back to the shore.
What of these creatures, the better?
And we gotta go back to camp one last time. Do one more tag in before we hit the Avvar keep.
Don't waste time on them. Head for the castle.
Listen, you can read them all apart.
The history of the Grey Wardens is fascinating.
Thank you. exhausting! Face me! I am the hand of God himself!
I will remember this when it is over.
This? This war? The Inquisition?
The people. How you fought against the tide. It is courageous.
I've dealt with the Avvar. Is everyone all right?
Yes, your worship. The injured need some rest, but we can return on our own.
I can't believe the Herald came for us.
I told you she'd come.
Looks after you, Herald. There lies the brat. His father, chief of our holding, would duel me for the loss if he cared enough.
The Inquisition has a purpose your chief lacks. Join me. Help us stop the breach.
Is this why the Lady of the Skies will be here? To help heal the wounds in her skin?
Aye. I'll join you. Let me make peace with my kin, and I'll find where you set your flag.
Okay, so with that, I'm gonna just talk a few more of the dialogue trees with some people, and then we're gonna get going on the main story once again, finally.
Now that we've got better maps, if you like, I can show you a few tricks to get more out.
That's worthless.
Thank you.
growling at everyone but your dogs.
No, no, go ahead. Who knows?
Do you need something?
May I ask you about the Chantry?
It is difficult to say what becomes of the Chantry now. They have no Templars, no leadership, and no one left who is worthy of succeeding the Divine. It has fallen apart when everyone needs it the most. I ache to think what this will mean in the days to come.
What influence does Chancellor Roderick really wield?
He's a bureaucrat, responsible for communicating the Divine's will to the rest of the Chantry. Therefore, he's accustomed to the clerics hanging on his every word, hoping his influence will benefit them. Despite that, Roderick is not a bad man. He's frightened, and believes his place is to fill the gap left by Most Holy's death. Some might agree. As far down the chain of command as he is, there is no one left above him.
How big a problem could he be?
No more than he is already. He sent his message to the College of Clerics. That is the only card he had to play. Dealing with him further only lends him credibility he doesn't deserve.
I'm surprised you rebelled against the Chantry.
I left my own order when they took the wrong path. It is no different. But in neither case did I stop caring. Indeed, I care so much that I feel drastic action is necessary. I suppose history shall one day judge my actions.
Will the Chantry replace Divine Justinia?
They will try. Once the priests withdraw for the Grand Consensus, it is against Chantry law for them to emerge without naming a new Divine. Sometimes it takes days, or weeks, or even months. The problem now is that no clear successor to Justinia exists. All worthy clerics died with her at the conclave.
So what happens if they can't agree on someone?
Theoretically, they will argue until exhaustion takes them or they see reason. Practically, however, if the Grand Consensus goes on too long, the Chantry will crumble. Any cleric with ambition but little sense will see this as her one chance, and plenty of such clerics exist. We shall see what happens. The Inquisition must act in the meantime.
If they do choose a new Divine, will you serve her?
That depends on whether she would have me. I am a rebel now, remember? And even if she would, I do not know. It would depend on what type of Divine she is. I am no longer in a position to follow blindly, and no new Divine could expect such obedience now.
Thank you.
Did you need something?
I'd like to know more about the Templars.
If you need insight into what the Order is doing now, I'm afraid I can't offer more than you already know. Anything else, I will answer as best I can.
What does Templar training involve?
There is weapon and combat training. Even without their abilities, Templars are among the best warriors and Thedas. Initiates must also memorize portions of the Chant of Light, study history, and improve their mental focus.
Did you enjoy your training?
I wanted to learn everything. If I was giving my life to this, I would be the best Templar I could.
You were a model student.
I wanted to be. I wasn't always successful. Watching a candle burn down while reciting the Chant of Transfigurations wasn't the most exciting task. I admit, my mind sometimes wandered.
You've lived in the Circle. What was a typical day for a Templar there?
Typical? The last time I was in a Circle was right before it fell apart. Nothing was typical.
Before that, then?
Certain rituals require a full guard. A mage's harrowing, for instance. I've attended a few. Most of the time, you merely maintain a presence, on patrol or in the Circle, ready to respond if needed. Mages pretend to ignore that presence, but they're watching you just as closely.
Do Templars and Mages never speak to each other?
Some do, but Templars are supposed to maintain a certain distance from their charges. If a Mage is possessed or uses blood magic, you must act quickly, without hesitation. Your judgment cannot be clouded. Of course, Ignoring one another does nothing to foster understanding.
Do the Templars do anything besides hunt mages?
Templars protect against the dangers of magic. Before the Order left the Chantry, that meant serving in a circle. They were also tasked with tracking apostates or fighting demons inevitably summoned by the weak or malicious.
What do you think of mages? Are they all a threat?
I've seen the suffering magic can inflict. I've treated mages with distrust because of it, at times without cause. That was unworthy of me. I will try not to do so here. Not that I want mages moving through our base completely unchecked. We need safeguards in place to protect people, including mages, from possession of the beast.
I think a lot of his mind on mages changed when Hawk spared the mages in the assault on the gallows.
Why did you join the Order?
I could think of no better calling than to protect those in need. I used to beg the Templars at our local chantry to teach me. At first, they merely humored me. I must have shown promise, or at least a willingness to learn. The Knight Captain spoke to my parents on my behalf. They agreed to send me for training. I was 13 when I left home.
13? That's still so young.
I wasn't the youngest there. Some children are promised to the Order at infancy. Still, I didn't take on full responsibilities until I was 18. The Order sees you trained and educated first.
What about your family? Did you miss them?
Of course, but there were many my age who felt the same. We learned to look out for one another.
Do Templars take vows? I swear to the Maker to watch all the mages. That sort of thing.
There's a vigil first. You're meant to be at peace during that time, but your life is about to change. When it's over, you give yourself to a life of service. That's when you're given a filter, your first draft of Lyria and its power. As Templars, we are not to seek wealth or acknowledgement. Our lives belong to the Maker and the path we have chosen.
A life of service and sacrifice. Are Templars also expected to give up physical temptations?
Physical? Why... why would you... That's not expected. Templars can marry, although there are rules around it, and the Order must grant permission. Some may choose to give up more to prove their devotion, but it's not required.
Have you?
Me? No. I've taken no such vows. Maker's breath. Can we speak of something else?
That's all I wanted to know. Thank you.
I'm sure you have other matters to attend.
Listen, Winston.
Had something with that kind of power. I'd be retired and living.
safely, Herald. Walk safely, Herald of Andraste. Make a watch over you.
With passioned breath, does the darkness creep?
How may I help you?
Do you need anything more, revered mother?
Sigrid says it will cost at least 10.
Fine.